Hello and welcome to Market Guru. Our guest today is R. Sukumar, MD and CIO of Franklin Asia Equities. Sukumar, thanks a ton for joining in. Now, I was just reading through your last public statement or the last time you were on public platform, and you did maintain that the pessimism in the market is so high that you won't be surprised by a big rally. And we have seen a big rally play out all through this week. Do you think that this rally is sustainable? Because still there is quite a bit of pessimism which is there in the market.
The nature of the market is that from, you know, the bear phase to the bull phase, you know, it, the transition, you know, it is not overnight. It can happen in terms of, you know, multiple rallies and then corrections and so on. But you know, key ingredient for a bull market is extreme pessimism. So we have that. I do not necessarily believe that at this point of time we have all the ingredients. I think the other ingredients required are some acceleration in earnings growth and improvement in corporate profitability and so on. I think these are likely to happen over a period of time. Whether it's going to happen immediately, I'm not so sure. But if you take a 2-year time frame, it looks like there's a very good chance of a reasonable upside compared to the current levels.
Sukumar, the last earnings season wasn't exactly bad for the market. So in that sense, can we say that the worst of the earnings downgrades is over and maybe there is a chance of an earnings upgrade? Or do you think there could be still be some lag effect of the kind of monetary policy we had and the GDP numbers that we had, and there could still be some risk for the corporate earnings?
I think it's still going to be mixed. I don't think you're going to see a clear direction in terms of upgrades or downgrades. But the key is that, the current prices of the investable universe of stocks already reflect, conservative estimates. So as things start looking up for a period of time, then I think there can be upside to stock prices.
Sukumar, the last time we spoke to you, you did say that you expected cyclical improvements in India and the fact that maybe there would be some improvement in the macro factors. From the evidence of what you have seen so far, do you stand by that view? Do you see some more cyclical improvement for India going forward?
I still believe it's going to happen. In terms of timing, probably that's been delayed a little bit compared to my earlier expectations. Because the political climate has continued to be more difficult than what I had expected. And I think the confusion among companies and the lack of trust between the government and the corporate sector seems to have escalated rather than reduced. So to that extent, I think the timing of improvement in investments has got delayed a bit. I still believe that they will improve, might be starting from, the fourth quarter of the current year.
Now, one of that macro factors, Sukumar, is the currency. Are you getting a sense that we have seen the worst of the currency depreciation? We've fallen about 25% over last 1 year, but this really is it, and the doomsday kind of scenarios of 62, 64, that may not happen?
What I would like to say is that on a sustainable basis, it is unlikely that the currency will be at a higher level compared to what it is now. When there is extreme volatility due to global uncertainties or some local issues, it's possible that the currency can be a little volatile, and on a temporary basis, it can deteriorate from the current levels. I think that there can be some improvement in exports. India can gain market share. And also, the imports have become expensive. There's already some trend of slowdown in gold exports. And there's also some reduction in oil prices. This could lead to some reduction in imports. So from a trade point of view and a current account point of view, it looks like we have seen the worst.
In the last week of April, Sukumar, your view was that the market needs to tone down the expectations on rate cuts. And to be fair, that at that time, the market had also cut the expectations. But after that, the kind of global commodity play that we have seen, whether it's crude falling to 100 or below that actually on the Brent, or that GDP number which came out as a bit of a shocker, again the market is expecting a rate cut. In fact, consensus is that 25 basis point is already factored in, and maybe there could be a 50 basis point rate cut as well. Where do you stand on that? Would you say that maybe now there is slightly more chance of a rate cut than it was in the end of April when you said that expectations need to be toned down?
The primary focus of the Reserve Bank of India should be to control inflation. So they have to look at multiple parameters to see whether the inflationary pressures are under control. Falling GDP growth is normally an indication that inflationary pressures will come under control. But if there are some policy actions which push up the prices of some products, then in spite of slowing growth, the inflation might not come down so much. So I think the key would be how the government looks at some of the regulated prices, you know, whether they're going to keep increasing the minimum support price, and how the agriculture production is going to be. So all these things are going to become critical, and I think will play a part in RBI deciding on the rates.
Sukumar, which way do you see this whole global mess actually ending? Because there's quite a bit of mud right now which is coming out of Europe, and nobody really knows what would happen. What do you think is a best case scenario for India?
The best case scenario for India is the current account deficit comes down substantially, and so the pressure on the external account reduces meaningfully. And that could happen if there is a continued decline in crude oil prices. That would have a very favorable impact on current account deficit. It would also have a very favorable impact on the government deficit, because a big portion of the deficit is because of petroleum product subsidies, and reduction in global crude prices will have a very favorable impact on that. So if the twin deficits were to show a very sizable improvement, then India, relative to other markets, will look more attractive, because India is dependent more on domestic demand, and the big concerns are because of the twin deficits. And a reduction in the twin deficit would definitely improve the confidence on India as a market, and that could make it much more attractive compared to many other emerging markets.
Sukumar, what are the cash levels in your funds right now, and would you look to deploy some of the funds at the current levels?
The cash levels are at normal levels. We do not normally time the market. So the cash level varies from fund to fund depending on the buys and sells that are being executed by the portfolio manager on a week-to-week basis. But they are in the normal level of around 5%, little less or little higher depending on the fund.
Sukumar, do you think the Indian market still remains a bottom-up market? Because in the last two or three weeks, there are some analysts who have come out and said that maybe it's time to look at India on a top-down approach. As a fund manager, would you continue to look at individual stocks and continue to have a bottom-up approach?
We believe that a substantial amount of outperformance for a medium to long term will come because of stock selection. So that would continue to be the prime focus for our portfolio management team.
Sukumar, the couple of interesting points is that this market is really making no distinction between high beta and defensives in the last 2 weeks. It's not that the market rally is seeing fall in defensives despite high valuations. That's an interesting point. Where do you stand on, say, portfolio positioning with regard to defensives? Would you still go out and invest in some of these stocks with the kind of valuations that they have, or would you now stay clear of defensive stocks?
Every stock in the portfolio, we have to look at what is the upside based on the intrinsic value and the targets that we have on the stocks. So the stocks that fit into, go through our filters will find a place in our portfolio, and others wouldn't.
Sukumar, what about IT stocks, the sector as a whole? Do you like it, and would you continue to bet on this one?
IT, we believe that the growth going forward would be lower compared to what we have seen historically. It's primarily because the size of the industry has increased substantially, and Indian IT companies have become mainstream, and so their growth over a period of time will convert towards the overall IT spending growth. So IT spending growth has always been in single digits, has never been in double digits. So which means that over a period of time, the growth for Indian companies will go into single digits. I'm not saying all companies, but if you're looking at the sum total. So the individual companies can do better, provided they have a proposition to offer clients, you know, in terms of new products or new services or ability to gain market share. So those type of companies can continue to grow faster. So apart from growth issues, we also have margin issues. I think generally the margins are going to decline because when there's going to be consolidation, the normal margins for a oligopolic structure would be lower compared to what it is for the industry at this point of time. So we have to evaluate companies based on these trends. There are some companies which we think are investment worthy in spite of potential decline in margins and potential decline in growth rates. And there are many companies which are not investment worthy.
Sukumar, the last 2 weeks have seen the return of PSU banking stocks. Are you getting a sense that the worst of the asset quality issues are over there? And given the kind of valuations that these stocks are trading at, despite the kind of rally over last week, would they be buy or would they be avoid for you right now?
There can be a respite there because they have seen a lot of bad news, and on a short-term basis, there might be incrementally no more bad news to come. So there can be some small rallies. But we believe on a structural basis, they will continue to lose share to the private sector banks. Their return on capital will be inferior to private sector banks. So as a long-term investment proposition, we find more ideas within the private sector banking space than the state-owned banking space.
So Sukumar, finally, I mean, going forward, can the Indian markets really outperform, or do you think we'll maybe perform in line with what's been happening in global markets? If we solve our domestic macros, do you think there is a chance for India to outperform the global markets?
I think the chances of outperforming are quite high at this point of time compared to what we have seen in the last 2 years. So I'm quite positive that there are good chances that India will outperform other emerging markets.
All right, Sukumar, thanks a lot for dropping by and talking to us. Appreciate your time and your views. Thanks a lot for talking to us. That's the call coming in from R. Sukumar, MD and CIO, Franklin Asia Equities. He remains optimistic on the market and believes that the rally can go on in India, provided domestic situation is sorted out. That's Market Guru for today. Thanks a lot for watching.